present I'm Sorry I Haven't a Clue, the antidote to panel games. At the piano is Colin Sell, and your chairman is Humphrey Lyttelton.
Hello and welcome to I'm Sorry I Haven't a Clue. You're welcome to join us this week in Bradford at the fine Alhambra Theatre. Bradford is not only a tiny picturesque village of mellowed bath stone cottages nestling along the banks of the River Avon. But is also 150 miles away in Wiltshire. As today we're in the Yorkshire city of Bradford, which boasts a rich and varied history. The name of the town is derived from Broad Ford because of the river crossing here, which was wide and convenient for dumping stolen escorts. Originally a small Saxon village, little of the original settlement survives, apart from a fine 15th century cathedral, which took 194 years to complete. A construction period of nearly two centuries may seem ridiculous to us, but of course builders were a lot quicker in those days. The town's prosperity grew thanks to the wool trade, and during the royalist siege of the Civil War, balls of wool were even hung on the city walls to protect them from cannon fire. This proved largely ineffective as the royalists held large numbers of playful kittens to bat them on the wall. The productivity of the woolen mills was raised beyond measure in 1798 with the arrival of steam power. The engineer James Watt, who, having noticed how the steam from a boiling kettle forced its lid open, was inspired to build his labour-saving machine. With reciprocating three-foot piston cylinders connected by a massive cast-iron cantilever beam, Watt had created the world's first seven-ton tea's made. Bradford is also known for the arts, and the composer Frederick Delius was born here. He, of course, wrote Sonata for Strings and Dance Rhapsody No. 2, but is perhaps best remembered for Delius' How to Cook. Bradford was also known for the excellence of its Edwardian theatre, which pioneered pantomime, music hall and classical drama. It was here in 1905 that the great actor-manager Sir Henry Irving, then in the twilight of his life, made his last performance. Having given a hushed audience his bloody Thomas à Becket murder scene, Irving sadly collapsed and died. It was most unfortunate as he was actually playing Widow Twankey at the time. But there's more to Bradford today than just famous people dying on stage. Let's meet the teams. They are on my left, Barry Cryer and Graeme Garden. And on my right, Tim Brooke-Taylor and Sandi Toksvig. And please welcome the lovely lady whose enthusiasm and eagerness to score makes things so easy for us. The ever delightful Samantha. OK, let's get on with the first round, which I noticed this week is called Round One. And as one might guess from that title, it's all about words and their meanings. For example, many people are ignorant about the difference between imply and infer. Imply describes the expression or suggestion of a notion in a subtle or indirect manner, whereas infer describes somebody who makes his living selling mink coats. As words are constantly changing their meanings, I'd like the teams to share with us any that they may have noticed recently. Sandi, would you care to start, please?
Rebut, having your bottom lifted.
Minuscule, a toddler's playgroup in Liverpool.
Tim?
Mastiff, boys at a Mastiff, boys at a Britney Spears concert. I got overexcited.
Dentist, man who fixes your car.
Lactose, the effect of frostbite.
Dissident, foreigner pointing out damage to your car. Disguise, pointing out the foreigner who's pointing out...
Cocker leaky, prostate problem.
That's not clever and it's not funny.
Custard. To swear after stepping in something.
Dilatory, conservative sex aid.
You can tell them what to do with it, I don't think. Donut, eccentric millionaire. Donut, you see, it's an eccentric millionaire. If I could say, not a millionaire, I got that completely wrong, and I'm a complete and utter ass. Good night.
Tim Brooke-Taylor, who died today.
Hullabaloo, how to greet a bear.
Fiasco, unsuccessful wall painting.
Bordello, blasé greeting.
Geranium, the cry of the parachute regiment's flower arranging display team.
Castigate, to have a nasty accident climbing into a field.
Combat, an aggressive marsupial.
Artifact, pretentious statistic.
Onion bhajie, French canal boat.
Hebrew, Jewish tea bag.
Moving on, I see the next game is Sound Charades. This is based on the erstwhile television favourite Give Us a Clue, where teams of players used to delight their audience by miming the titles of songs, films or plays against a strict time limit. The most highly skilled of all was Lionel Blair. But how the tears of frustration welled up in his eyes during their Italian tour at not being allowed the use of his mouth to finish off Two Gentlemen of Verona. Tim and Sandy, you're to start, please, and your title will shortly be displayed to the audience via laser display board. For listeners at home, here's the mystery voice.
Dirty Harry. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.